is Jerry Wide. I've been fishing the local area since I was six and caught some pretty impressive fish over the years along the way. But nothing prepared me for what I've read in a local paper a few days ago. Boy bitten by huge fish in the River Stour. Well, naturally, this got me interested and I had to track down the village that he lives in and try and find him. This I did, and I even managed to get the live footage of the incident that his sister had taken at the time. This is the area where the boy was bitten, in Holbrook Bay, and I know this area really well. I've fished it since I was 14, so shouldn't be too difficult to try and track down whatever the monster fish is. Some of the spots I plan to try are very remote and will take 1 or 2 hours to walk to, so I'm going to have to travel light. By the tooth mark still showing in the boy's leg around the wound, whatever this was has got some serious teeth, so we're going to have to tackle it with something pretty sturdy. Now, I've stopped some pretty big tope in my time using a 150-pound mono and a 9-0 circle hook, so that's what I propose to use, probably with half a mackerel as bait. This will be connected to a zip slider and a normal breakout weight and a rubbing leader of about 50 pounds just to combat any roughness on the side of the fish, whatever it is. On the video, I could see that the fish has got 9 spines on its back, which normally would mean that would be a bass, but of course they only grow to about 18 to 19 pounds, so it seems highly unlikely, but that could be our starting point. During the long trek to my chosen spot, I constantly studied the water surface for any predator activity, such as bait fish being attacked. The bait chosen is half a mackerel on a 9-0 circle hook, the head always being the most tempting part for large predators. We'd been fishing for a couple of hours with no bites when suddenly the ratchet screamed and the line was pouring off the reel. So I struck and the battle commenced. The fish made off in a powerful run that I just couldn't stop. I even burnt my thumb trying to slow it down. And then it was gone. Whatever that was, just took half the line off the reel and bit through a 150-pound mono as though it had a pair of pliers with it. Very, very sharp teeth. Even a tope won't go through this mono, so I don't know what that was, but I couldn't stop it. We're dealing with a real monster here, and it shouldn't be in the Stour. Hopefully, next time, we're going to have more success in stopping whatever this beast is. Day two, on a different location, we hooked another big fish. Although much smaller than the one we lost yesterday, it put up a spirited fight in choppy conditions. This one we successfully landed. Amazingly, it was a giant bass, but with teeth like a shark. The fish tipped the scales at 46 pounds, nearly three times the current British bass record. How big was the one that got away? I guess we'll never know.